Okay, I gotta ask a question or make a video on what do you do when your horse spooks out on a trail? And I think I cover that in a lot of my sacking out videos, but I figured I'd address it specifically so I could get the title in case somebody's looking. Easy, Mr. T. I know you're in a hurry to get back because your boys are out there in pasture. Me and Mr. T just went out for a ride, and when we came back, this trash can was knocked over, so he kind of looked at it kind of funny. And because he looked at it funny, that told me that he was worried about it or confused or couldn't see or couldn't tell if it was a predator. And he was telling me, I tell people a lot, your horse is always talking to you if you listen. When Mr. T kind of cocked his head and he slowed down, he looked at that trash can like, what is that? Now, I knew it was a trash can. I knew it wasn't going to hurt him, but he didn't know that. And he told me he didn't know that, by the way. Good boy, Mr. T, you flexing, saying, can we get going? He didn't know that, so he told me that. How did he tell me that? He got slower. He changed his pace. He kind of balled up. His head went high. He moved his head up and down, and he looked at it kind of funny and went, I can't tell. And he switched from monocular vision to binocular vision, and he went from one eye to two eyes, and his head tilted, and it went up and down, and somebody else would have went, you know, got angry at the horse. Stupid horse getting spooky. It's just stupid trash can. We passed right by it when we walked away. Okay, that's somebody that doesn't understand a horse. That's somebody that's not a horseman. That's somebody that wants, you know, the perfect horse and wants to blame the horse because they don't understand the horse and they don't know how to help the horse get through his natural instinctual fear. I got another question about a horse that, how do you know when a horse is ready to ride on trails? Well, you know, you never know if a horse is ready to ride on trails. You do your homework, you set up a good foundation, you start them off on short trips, you ride them around a barn, you ride them around a round pen, you ride them in enclosed areas so he gets used and he knows what to expect. And here comes a big old truck and he's going to come right by us here. So I'm going to back Mr. T up, but I want to back him up before this truck gets here so he doesn't think that the truck's scaring us. But I didn't want that truck spooking him and him jumping right into it. And because I had this phone in his hand, with only one hand on the reins, and he's standing there on a loose rein in his little halter. Oh, I tried to film you over here, and you could turn your head the other way. I see how you are. Poor Mr. D. Look up, boy. So, always being aware of what's going to happen and where a horse is going to go for danger. Mr. T's facing forward, so if something scares him from behind, he's going to lunge forward. But if something scares in front of him, he may lunge forward and try to run by him. He doesn't know that car's traveling at 60 miles an hour and he can't stop. So it's up to me to give him direction and to keep him safe. And I tell people that a lot about, you know, you want to be nice to a horse, you want to love them. If you can't control them and you can't keep them safe and you can't make them listen to you, then you don't love that horse. You're making him more dangerous and you're just setting him up to fail. And if he fails with you on it, you both get hurt. And if he fails with you on the ground, well, sometimes he just gets hurt. But either way, it's unnecessary. So let me get back on topic here about this trash can. Mr. T showed me a little discomfort, a little insecurity, a little lack of confidence when he saw this trash can. He's been by 100 trash cans. I tie trash cans to a rope and drag it. So there's no doubt in my mind that he knows what a trash can is. But by him giving me a reaction that was insecure, a lack of confidence, he told me, hey, you know what, we haven't done this in a while. I'm not real sure about this trash can. Maybe you need to give me a refresher course. Maybe I'm seeing if you're paying attention to me. Maybe if I spook at this trash can, act a little scared, and you don't give me the confidence that I'm looking for, then maybe my fear is justified because your lack of direction, because of your lack of confidence, because of your lack of leadership. So, because Mr. T showed me a little bit of concern, we're going to walk by this trash can. I'm not going to walk, you know, now if he was snorting and everything, I wouldn't walk him right by it. But now his ears are kind of going, and now he kind of ignored it. He still gave me that one eye, and I could tell that. So we're going to pass this. Of course, he wants to get to his herd, and he sees his herd mates out there. So we're going to turn. We're going to go back to this trash can. Now Buddy's calling to him, so that's another distraction. You saw that ear. Oh, you saw that ear go back. When he heard Buddy call, he flicked that left ear to him. See that left ear going back to Buddy? That left ear is to Buddy, it's not to me. So he's looking at the truck, but his ears are back at Buddy, and his ears are going to go back to the truck to see if it's friend or foe. And all these little signals are telling me. And now he's staring at this trash can, and see his head dropping? He's trying to use the binocular. He's trying to say, is there something in that trash can? He doesn't know if there's a predator in that trash can. He doesn't know if it's going to get him. So we're going to walk in between this trash can, if I can get these reins here, good boy, we're going to walk next to this trash can. And they're going to walk next to this trash can. And his head went a little high, and he went, you know what, I'm not too sure about that trash can. So all I'm going to do is build his confidence with this trash can. We're going to stop next to this trash can. We're going to stand next to this trash can. I'm going to let him relax by this trash can. I'm going to let him see when he wanted to walk away from that trash can, which isn't good. So we're going to turn back around. We're going to face this trash can and stop. And he's going to have to drop his head and smell and touch this trash can and let me know that, you know what, I'm not scared of this trash can. I don't care about this trash can. So we got a trash can there, we got a trash can here, he's looking around, but he's not paying attention to that trash can so much. And I'm not paying attention, there, that's what I wanted, that's what I wanted. He's like, hey, you know what, maybe this thing ain't gonna hurt me. So I didn't force him, I didn't shove him, I didn't put 20 trash cans in his stinking stall and say, deal with your fear, stupid horse, I'll show you, I'll put 100 trash cans in your stall, and you're not ever gonna spook. That doesn't do anything, that just shows your ignorance. It shows somebody's ignorance when they get out there and do stupid stuff with horses and try to impress other people and give other people advice about how they got to show the horse who's boss and how they got to teach the horse manners. That's the key word that I'm hearing more and more. Used to be respect my space is the horse term. Here comes a car, so I got to be ready on these loose reins to pull back in case that spooks him. He didn't do anything, but I'm really being aware, and that's just called awareness. And a horse knows what's going to happen. He's aware of everything. And if you're not, you're going to get caught with your pants down. You're going to get caught, and your horse is going to spook and jump out from underneath you, and you're going to end up falling off. And then you'll be running around telling people how your horse threw you and what a good rider you are because you got back on. And trying to impress somebody that don't know. So we're standing here next to this trash can. So this is how, when your horse spooks at something, I don't make it a fight. I don't focus on the trash can. I focus on control and communicating with my horse. I focus on building him confidence and show him, you know what? If you pay attention to me, we're going to be okay. I'm not going to make you do something that's going to get hurt. Now, if I try to make this horse walk over this trash can, and I'm sure I can make Tanner walk over that trash can. First of all, it's not my trash can, so I don't want to damage it. But if it was something that I wasn't worried about, and I made him walk over it, he would walk over it, and it would build his confidence. But if I walked him over it and his foot got caught in there, or his hoof got caught, and he slipped, then I made it worse. So, you know, when you're doing sacking out and you're trying to teach your horse lessons and trying to help him deal with his fear, you got to be aware. I can't make the situation worse. I can't do more damage. I can't make the horse worse off than when I got on him. You know, I said this before and I say it again. The horse you get on is not the horse you get off. The horse changed. And whether he changes for the better or for the worse is up to you. Because the horse is just a reflection of what we do. There's a plastic bag right there, and it kind of blew a little bit. And I don't know if you saw him kind of give that a little glance. I caught it. The wind blew it, and it moved a little bit. He didn't spook at it. He was just kind of like, why is that thing moving? He's being aware. He's looking around. He's not being spooky. He's like, you know what? We're sitting here on the street. There's cars come by. There's this trash can that I wasn't really too confident about, but I'm getting more confident now that I'm standing here. Nothing's happening. I'm not getting spurred. I'm not having my pain in a bit. Nobody's trying to flex me. Nobody's trying to show me who's boss. I got my herd behind me. They're out in pasture. And I'm just kind of standing here relaxing, waiting for my leader to tell me what to do. I'm being a good horse, waiting for some direction. Now, if I don't give him direction here in a while, he'll ask. He'll try to walk off. He'll try to say, hey, are you paying attention? Is it okay if I walk off? Here comes a car. That car's going to slow down and go the other side of the road, which is very nice. A lot of people will zoom right by in the same lane. I don't know about your state, but in California, cars are required to slow down when passing an animal, either driven by cart or being on horseback. And it's against the law to speed by a horse. Of course, most people don't know it, and most people don't care. And unless you make a big issue of it, probably won't be enforced. But knowing your horse laws in your area can help kind of maybe make people aware of what's going on. There's a sign right there that says horse crossing, but most people pay attention to that like they do, you know, sign that says deer crossing. Nobody slows down. So anyway, Mr. T's standing here, and now he's taking a couple steps back. I'm not asking him to back up. He took a couple steps back. He goes, he's not giving me any direction. Maybe I'll just back up. Now, was he backing up to get on flatter ground? Was he backing up to get off a couple of rocks? Was he backing up maybe because a fly was on him? He's trying to scratch him off? I don't know. You know, I don't want to jump to conclusion that he was backing up being disrespectful. He wasn't listening to me. How dare he move when I didn't tell him? I'm going to make him stand where he needs to stand, and this horse needs to listen, and he shouldn't be dancing. You know, when I hear all these trainers and clinicians or, you know, horse experts or barn managers or somebody that's owned horses a whole life start telling people how to control their horse all the damn time, I just look at them and got to shake my head. And it's really sad that the horse has to end up suffering because of all the ignorance out there. Don't listen to all that crap. Have a relationship with your horse. Understand your horse. Be able to sit here on a loose rein with your horse. This truck's slowing down. I think it's going to turn here because they're working. It is turning. My horse stand here on a loose rein. He's got one leg, one hip is relaxed, and he's kind of leaning on one side. You know, some people, I've heard some old cowboys say, you don't let that horse relax that leg. He needs to stand up and support your body. You start letting him do that, and he'll be running all over you. Look, if my horse wants to relax his leg, he can relax his leg. If he wants to look around and be curious, he can look around. I'm not going to have his head secure and holding and squeezing and controlling. And all that is just really bad for a horse, and I preach that a lot because it seems like that's all I see out there. I don't see good horsemanship. And maybe I'm looking in the wrong spot, and maybe it's where I'm riding and going, but it just seems like everywhere I go, you know, this new fang-dangled respect my space, show the horse who boss, teach them manners has taken over the horse world, and now horses are just miserable when they're being ridden or when they're with their owner, and it just doesn't have to be that way. Mr. T just shift weights, and he shifted his other foot, because I'm standing here, and my butt's heavy, and he's got a lot of weight on his back, and if he wants to relax a little bit, it's a partnership, you know? If I was going to be here much longer, I'd go ahead and get off and give his back a rest. I'll get off and loosen his cinch and let him get some circulation in his belly, fluff his hair up. Now, he's not paying attention to this trash can right now, and he's being pretty good, so now I'm just going to walk off, and we're going to go ahead and head back to the barn. Let's go, Mr. T. I know, you're a good boy. Let's go this way. We're going to walk in between these trash cans. We're going to head back to the barn. He's going to be okay. And now he's a better horse because of how we dealt with that. And we dealt with that together as a partnership, not as a master and slave. And I think a car's coming behind me, so I need to look behind me. You saw Mr. T's head. Okay, there's a car way back there. Good boy, Mr. T. All right, we'll go down this hill. Come on, let's go down here. Come on, pay attention. There you go. Good boy. What a good boy. There's a plastic cup. There's a hot wire here to the left, so I got to be careful that I don't let him sniff over there. He may try and grab grass there and grab that hot wire, and then if I'm not paying attention, I get myself in trouble. So, hold Mr. T. Oh, good boy. Okay, so dealing with things on the trail, when your horse spooks at something, try to get him over his fear. Try to help him understand what happened. Try to let him know that it's okay to be scared, but I'm going to help you. Well, I don't want him getting that close to that hot wire. Talk to your horse. Let him know. I'm going to go ahead and walk him back on the road so we can stop here and I'll finish this up. All right. See, now I moved Mr. T from all those distractions because we had that hot wire there. We had all that grass to eat. And I wanted him to pay attention to stand here. So I moved him away. I see a lot of people trying to train horses around fresh green grass and then they want to get in a fight with their horse about eating the grass and trying to eat and stopping them from eating and doing all that. Instead of setting a horse still and say, you know what, if I want to teach you something new and I want you to pay attention, I'm gonna lessen the distractions. I'm gonna move you to where there's no grass. I'm gonna get in an area that's kind of quiet that I can control you a little bit. Now we got close to the barn and he got a little antsy here. You see this blowing and snorting? Now he's a little irritated with these flies, but he's telling me he's irritated because he wants to go back to the barn. And a lot of times that little blow and snort, see him backing up, see him snorting and shaking that head. He's telling me he's a little frustrated, and I'm at 14 minutes. I didn't know I was that long. Anyway, hope that helps on dealing with scary things out in out on trail riding. All right, good boy, Miss T. I know you touched my boot. I'll let you go to the barn. All right, here we go. That'll do that one. Hope that helps. Good boy, Mr. T.